How can you create graphs like this in Power BI, and why these graphs can be very effective for business data as well? We have seen graphs like this. This one actually comes from Walks, and we would link to the original video in the description below. But these graphs can also be very effective for business data. Let me show you with an example. Here we have data from a car manufacturer, and the challenge here is that these models were launched at different dates. Now, if you show the classic sales over time graph for these different models, it's gonna look like this. As you can see, it's really, really cluttered, and it's hard to tell the winners from the losers. And of course, the biggest challenge is that you can see that there are quite a few models were launched around this time, but then some model was launched later on and later on and later on. And how do you compare those to all of them and get a clearer picture? Well, you can do that using a since day zero style graph just like this one. And the same data, so the same confusing data, if laid out in that since day zero graph in Power BI, actually looks like this. You can see how beautiful it is and how clearly it's conveying the picture. I mean, you can clearly see where the winners are and the folks who are in the middle of the pack and the folks who are not really pulling their weight. So that's the beauty of the since day zero graph, but it's wait, there's more. Now, this pattern, of course, you can use it for showing product sales since the launch date, but this is a very generic pattern of basically showing a measure since a start date. And you can find applications for this in pretty much any industry or any data you're working for. I'll just show you some examples. So for example, in marketing, you might have campaigns that have different start dates. Again, the same challenge. They have different start dates, but you want to compare their performance since the start of the campaign. You can do that using this since day zero style graph. Let's talk about human resources. Different employees may have different join dates, but you might want to show them up since the date they joined. And you might want to track their vacation hours or training hours or something else since their join date. And you can do that using this style of graph. Let's take our last example about project management. Again, different projects can have different project start dates, but you can line them up side by side and compare and really see what's going on by this style of graph when you show hours worked since project start. So let's get into it and let's see how we can build this graph. My name is Avi Singh. I'm a Microsoft MVP and best-selling Power BI author. And if you want to become a Power BI pro, make sure to subscribe and yes, click that bell so you are notified whenever I go live to answer your Power BI questions. Now, if you're getting started or keep getting stuck in Power BI, then make sure to check out our number one ranked Power BI tutorial. And we're going to put a link to that in the corner and down in the description. So let's move on and build our since day zero graph. So we're gonna start with the data that looks like this. And in the end, we wanna get something that looks like this, the cumulative totals in the since day zero style pattern that we talked about. Now, of course, you can build something like this. And then if you like, extend it to build automation. So you can see, so we're not going to cover this in this video, but you can certainly build automation on top of that. Okay, so let's get back in our file and get started. So we're going to do this in three steps, ABC. And by the way, this was inspired by a question that was asked by Diego Lopez, a part of a Learn Power BI family, in one of our earlier Talk Power BI episodes. So Diego, thank you for asking this question. So let me just give you a lay of the land. So here we have sales data and in the classic data lookup table schema, we have location, product, and calendar table. Now you can see that if we show this by calendar table, it looks very messy. So what we really need is a different kind of calendar table, a calendar since launch table. And we're gonna build that in our transform data. So let's open up our query editor and we're gonna build it over there. So this is gonna be our step A right here. So we're gonna add a special calendar table. So I have my transform data screen up, if I can find it, there we go. And what I'm gonna do here is just say new blank query. I'm gonna change its name, and I have the query for this laid out already, and I'm just going to paste this in the advanced editor. By the way, I'm not going to go into this in more detail because this essentially is very, very similar to the pattern that we have for our ultimate calendar table. So this special table has been built following the same pattern. And by the way, if you haven't seen that, you must watch that video. This is perhaps the most important table in any Power BI model, the calendar table. And we're going to put links in the corner and in the description down below where you can watch this video and download the ultimate calendar table for free. So just to give you an idea, so again, this is a special calendar table. This does not have dates. This has days since launch because that's what we are interested in, right? So we're saying, you know, after day one, day two, and day three. Now, of course, being a calendar table, it can also group these days into months or quarters. So if you want to see things at a different granularity. But again, so kind of like a calendar table, but slightly special. So we have this table now, and now we got to do the next step, which is we got to add something in the sales table, which will let us link it with this table. So again, the key for this table is not dates, it is days since launch. So we need pretty much the same column in our sales table. So we're going to go here and build that here. And for this, the first thing I'm going to do is I have noticed the product ID key, and in my product table, I have the product ID key, but I also have a launch date. So I'm going to grab that first. So I'm going to go in my sales table and I'll say merge queries. Merge with the product table on product key. Hit OK. And expand this, and the only column that I'm interested in is in launch date, so let me get that. And now I can add a custom column, days since launch. And here I can simply say purchase date minus the launch date, and it's as easy as that. And this is the part that I love about the kitchen of Power BI, the query editor. And that it has a trash can. If you have no idea what I'm talking about, go check out my 60-minute tutorial that I referenced earlier. Cool, so I can get rid of the column after I've used it. And for this one, I need to change it to whole number. And we're ready to go. So I'm gonna load this data and be right back. All right, my data has been loaded and the relationship was detected automatically as well. If it isn't, then it's a very simple relationship. Just these are connected in a one-to-many relationship using the days since launch column. So let's see what we can do with this. So we had this table that we were starting with. And again, kind of really messy. And the biggest challenge was that these models were launched later on in the year. So how it's, you know, you can't really compare them side by side. So I'm going to grab this graph and put that in here. And instead of the calendar table, which is what I'm using right now, I'm going to switch that field to use the calendar since launch instead. So actually, didn't want to do that. Remove the month year. And instead of that, I'm going to put the month number on the axis. But this is a special month number. This is month number since launch. And well, this is probably not what you expected. Now, trust me, this is still progress. Now, if you notice what has happened here, it has lined up everything on this side. So in the earlier graph, this is the before picture, there was stuff that was starting at different dates, right? I mean, August and 2018 and so forth. So what this has done is it has lined up everything. Like, oh, everything starts at day zero. But this is still not the same because we only need to do one more step, which is instead of showing the actual sales for that, we just need to show cumulative sales. So that's the only measure we need to add. And we're going to do that as our last step here. All right, so let's go to the sales table, go to modeling, and we're going to create a new measure. Now I'm just going to paste this formula in. Now, for those of you who are part of my Learn Power BI program, you would recognize that this is the same exact formula that we cover inside the program, Inner Time Intelligence Measures, when we are covering month-to-date, quarter-to-date, year-to-date, and then life-to-date measures, time intelligence measures, and this is pretty much the life-to-date pattern. By the way, folks, if you are interested in our training programs, then just head to our website, learnpowerbi.com. Then under training, you can find our Learn Power BI course and join the wait list to be notified as soon as it opens. Okay, so now that we have the cumulative measure, I'm gonna copy this graph, put that in our next step. And all I need to do is swap out that measure. So I'm gonna remove the sales quantity and instead add the cumulative sales quantity. And there you go. Again, the since day zero style of graph for our business data. And as I said earlier, this is a very flexible pattern, can be applied in a lot of different scenarios and in pretty much any industry. Now, I had mentioned the play axis. That is a little bit advanced. We would not be able to cover this in this video. In fact, this one is covered in our advanced Power BI program. So if you go back to our site and look under training, look for Pro Level. That is our advanced Power BI training program. And you can find information about that on our site. If you want to download this file, then you can head to this link. We're also going to put this link in the corner and down in the description below. This video was created based on a question asked by Diego Lopez in our monthly Talk Power BI Q&A show. You can find more information on submitting questions and how to join this monthly call using the link shown right here. Click to keep watching our next video, and don't forget to subscribe, as that really helps support our channel and helps us put out great content. Until next time, power on, my friend.